Let us find the rank of this matrix. To find the rank of this matrix has to be in row echelon form. Now let us reduce this to the row echelon form. What row echelon form says? First non-zero entry here should be 1. It is already 1. Then after that what we do? We make all the elements below this entry, zeros. So we have to make this 3 as 0 first. Now how can we make this element as 0 with the help of this 1? So we have 1, we have 3. So what we do, we multiply this by minus 3. We multiply this by minus 3. So that you will get minus 3 here. Then we add these two. So your answer will be 0. Because minus 3 plus 3 will be 0 you will get. So what is the operation here? This is in the R1 place. So what we need to write? Minus 3 times R1 plus R2. Plus R2 we have done, right? So that is our new R2. This is our new R2. If you apply this operation on this row, you get this as the new row. Now let us see minus 3 times R1. What is R1? 1, 2. Plus R2. What is R2? 3, 6. If you multiply this minus 3 inside and add with these things, what will it? Minus 3 into 1 is minus 3 plus 3. Then minus 3 into 2 is minus 6 plus 6. So what is the new row you are going to get? 0, 0. So this is our new row R2. This is our new row R2 which has been replaced here in this place. Now it is reduced row echelon form. It is in row echelon form. Why? First non-zero entry is 1 and in the next row if you see there is no non-zero entry at all. That means this is a 0 row and it has come down. So we can stop here and count the number of non-zero rows. How many non-zero rows are there? This is one non-zero row. So rank of A is 1 here. Rank of A is 1. Now let us say this. Now we need to find the rank of this by reducing it to echelon form. What we have here, first entry is 2, but we want it has to be 1. Right? Let us not concentrate on 1 now. Let us see, can we make this as 0 with the help of 2? Can we make this element 0 with the help of 2? And can we make this element 0 with the help of 2? To make this element 0 with the help of 2, first I need to, let us take this 2 here and let us take this minus 1 here. So to make this element minus 1 as 0, what we do? First we have to divide this by 2. So that you will get 1 here. Then if you add, you will get 0. But the difficulty is, when you plan for this operation division by 2, you have to divide this also by 2 and this 4 also by 2. Then it becomes very difficult for the subtraction or addition of 2 with 3 by 2 and 3 with 4 by 2, because it will be in fractions 3, then you have to take the LCM and all. So for that reason, what we do is, let us interchange these two rows first. Let us interchange these two rows. So minus 1 will come in the first place. You can interchange these two rows, or you can interchange these two rows also. So preferably we prefer one to be in first place here. So let us interchange. They have interchanged R1 and R2. Let us interchange now. R1 interchanges with R2. If you do, you have this, right? Now it is very easy to make this element 0 with the help of minus 1, right? Now how? We have minus 1 here, then we have 2 here. What has to be done? We multiply this minus 1 by 2 so that you get minus 2. Then we add with this plus 2. Your answer will be 0. So your operation is multiply by 2 with R1. 2R1 plus R2 plus R2 we are doing. So this is how we make this element 0. Now how do we make this element 0? With the help of this 1. Sorry, this minus 1. We have minus 1. And we have plus 1. Right? Nothing to do, just add these two, you'll get the answer 0. That means R3 changes to R1 plus R3. R1 plus R3, if you do, you'll get 0 here. If you apply these two operations, on these two rows, what you get is these two new rows. This is new R2 and this is new R3. See, you can see we have made these elements as zeros with the help of these operations. Now what? Now, this was our leading entry, non-zero leading entry. Below that, we made all the elements 0. Then, in the second row, which is a non-zero entry, this is a non-zero entry, first non-zero entry, right? So, below this entry, we make this element as 0. We will think of making these elements as 1 later. We will think of making these elements as 1 later. For now, let us concentrate on only making the elements below the leading entry places zeros. This was our leading entry, non-zero leading entry, which was minus 1. Below that we made all zeros. In the second row, first non-zero leading entry is 7. Let us make below that this 7 as 0. Now which number we are going to use? We are going to use this 7. We use this 7 to make this 7 0. Right? Always this has to be done. Now what we have? 7 here. What we have? 7 here. So what has to be the operation? Just subtraction. Right? Or else you can multiply. Or else you can multiply this by minus 1. You get minus 7. Then you can add here. Then you can add. That means minus times R2 plus R3 elements. If you simplify these two, let us see what you get. Minus R2 0 7 n plus R3 0, 7, 10. What do you get? If you multiply this minus sign inside, 0, -7, -10 plus 0, 7, and 10. If you add 0 plus 0 is 0, -7 plus 7 is 0, -10 plus 10 is 0. Okay, this is our new R3, which has to replaced in this place. See, we are replaced. Now almost everything is done. Now only one case is left. That means we need to make these leading entries as one year. To make this leading entry as one, we need to divide this by, we need to divide this -1 by -1. If you divide -1 by -1, you'll get +1. So what is the operation we need to do? R1 divided by -1. Or you can write this as -1 into R1 in both the ways. You can divide by -1 or multiply by -1, right? See, here they have written finally -R1. Then how do you make this 7 as 1? We need to divide this 7 by 7 itself. So that means R2 divided by 7. That is also equivalent to 1 by 7 times R2. So we are going to change our new R2 in this way. In this way, this we have written 1 by 7 times R2. 1 by 7 times R2 yields. What it gives? When you divide this by -1 or multiply by this -1, minus into minus, plus. Minus into plus, minus into plus, minus. Then what happens here? When you divide by 7, 0 by 7 is 0, 7 by 7 is 1, then we write 10 by 7 as it is. Now it is a row echelon form, because first non-zero entry is 1. Then in the next row, if you see, the first non-zero entry, which is 1, lies right off this 1, right? Lies right off this 1. And when you go for the next row, all the elements are zeros. All the elements are zeros. If at all there is any, suppose if we have 5, then we have to divide by 5. Divide throughout by 5. Incidentally, we have come here as 0. So it is a 0 row. How many non-zero rows are there? We have 2 non-zero rows. So what is the rank? Rank of A is 2. So here what we learned? Not necessary to make these elements 1. Not necessary to make these elements 1 in the beginning. We can make the elements non-zero leading entries as 1 in the end also. First concentrate making these elements as zeros. Let us take up this problem. This is a 3 cross 4 matrix. This is a 3 cross 4 matrix. Now since in this matrix first non-zero entry is already 1, now we need to think of making these elements as zeros. we make this element 2 as 0 with the help of this 1. How do we make 1 here, 2 here? So what has to be multiplied here? Minus 2. So that it becomes minus 2 here. Then if you add, it becomes 0. So what is the operation? To this R1, to this R1 element, multiply by minus 2. Minus 2 R1, then add row 2 elements. Row 2 elements R2. Fine. Then how do we make this element 0? 1 here, then 1 here. So what we do, we multiply this by minus 1 so that it becomes minus 1. Then we add these two. You will get 0. So what we are multiplying? By minus 1. Minus times R1 elements plus R3 elements. If you apply the operations, what, let us see what you get. If you apply these operations, if you apply these operations, this is your new R2 and this is your new R3, right? Next, what can be done? This is over. Now look at the second row. First non-zero entry is 1, minus 1 here, which lies right off 1, no problem. Then we plan to make this entry as 0, below this non-zero leading entry, below this non-zero leading entry, we need to make all the elements zeros. What can be done here? We have minus 1, then here we have plus 1, right? Just addition. If you add these two, minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled, you will get 0. What is the operation? R3 changes to, we are going to change R3. R3 changes to R2 plus R3. R2 elements plus R3 elements. If you simplify this, you get new R3 as this. If you simplify this, you will get 0 row, completely 0. See? We were trying to make this element as 0, automatically all the elements are getting 0. No problem. This is a new R3 we got. Now what is the last step? Make this element as 1. Make this element as 1. How do we make? By multiplying this row by minus 1. By minus 1. Let us do that. Yeah. See, here we are multiplying minus 1 to R2 element so that we can get 1 in this place. 1 in this place. So this is nothing but R2 we are changing in this way. R2 we are changing in this way. It is a row echelon form. Right? Because we have 1 as the first non-zero entry here. Below that all the elements are zeros. When you look at the second row, first non-zero entry, which is 1, which lies the right of this 1, and below that all the elements are 0. When you look for third row, anyhow all the elements are zeros and it is a 0 row. How many non-zero rows are there? 2 non-zero rows. So what is the rank? Rank row of A is 2. Let us look at this problem. Here, first non-zero entry, we have got 0. It should be non-zero. It should be non-zero. So let us interchange these two. Let us interchange these two. If you interchange these two, you will get this. You will get this. Okay. Then, first non-zero entry is non-zero, fine. Then we try to make below that 2 all the element to be 0. This is anyhow 0. Let us not touch that. How do we make this element as 0? Using this 2. Yes, we have 2. We have 4. So what has to be multiplied with this so that we get minus 4 here? We have to multiply by minus 2, which gives minus 4. Then if you add these two, you get 0. So what is the number we are going to multiply with this R1? Minus 2. So let us write the operation. Minus 2 times R1 plus R3. If you simplify this, you will get new R3 as this. So we made these elements 0 below the first non-zero leading entry. Now when you look at the second row, first non-zero leading entry is 2 and which lies to the right of this leading entry, right? So what is our aim now? Make this element as 0 with the help of this 2. What we have 2 here and we have 2 here. What has to be done with this? Multiply by minus 1. You will get minus 2. Then we add. If we add, you will get 0. Right? So what is the number we have to multiply? Minus 1 with R2. So minus times R2 plus R3 will give you new R3. Let us see what is that new R3. Yeah. Let us apply this operation on this. If you simplify this, what do you get is, we are almost done. Only thing is, let us now make this element as 1 and make this element as 1. To make this element as 1, we need to divide R1 elements by 2. And to make this element as 1, we need to divide R2 elements by 2. So that is what we are saying, 1 by 2 times R1 comma 1 by 2 times R2 gives this. If you divide, you get 2 by 2 is 1, then 3 by 2, 5 by 2, 4 by 2 is 2. And here 0 by 2 is 0 itself, 2 by 2 is 1. 3 by 2 here, 4 by 2 is 2. Now you can observe, first non-zero leading entry is 1, below that we got all zeros. And in the second row, first non-zero leading entry is 1, below that we got zeros. When you come for third row, automatically we got a 0 row, right? So how many non-zero rows we have here? 2, therefore rank is two. Let us find the rank of this matrix. When you look at the first non-zero leading entry here, it is 2, right? If 1 is available here, better we exchange, better we exchange, right? Now let us exchange one now, exchange the rows R1 with R2, because one is available here, one is available. Let us interchange these two rows now. Yes, we have interchange. After interchanging, what we do, we make all these elements below this 1 to be 0. It is already 0. Yes, how can we make this element as 0? What operation we need to apply? With the help of this 1, we need to make this element 0. So we apply this operation. How can we make this element as 0? With the help of this 1, we can apply this operation. It is already 0, let us not touch this. Okay, if you apply these two operations, you will get your new R2 and new R3 in this way. So that you got all the elements below this 1 as zeros. Now here, this is our first non-zero leading entry, which is minus 5. When you observe the other rows, as we expect, we prefer 1 to be here, if 1 is available in this place in the other rows, better you interchange. Since 1 is available in this place, let us interchange these two rows. As we prefer 1 to be in this place. So we interchange R2 with R4. Yes, we have interchanged here. R2 with R4 we have interchanged. So we got 1 in this place as we prefer. Now what? We make this element as 0 and this element as 0 with the help of this 1. Yes, what we do? Here we have 1. Here we have minus 2. Right? Here we have minus 2. What has to be multiplied here? Plus 2. So that you get plus 2. Then if you add, you get 0. What is the number here we need to multiply with R2? 2. So we write R3 changes to, because we are going to change R3, row 3. This is where we want the element to be 0. So R3 changes to 2 times. 2 times R2 plus R3. Then how can we make this element as 0? Yes, we have 1. Here we have minus 5. So what number I need to multiply? 5. Which gives 5. Then if you add, you will get 0. So I need to multiply by 5 to R2. 5 times R2 plus R4. Right? These are the operations. Let us apply these operations on these two rows and see what new rows we get. If you apply these operations on these two rows, these are the new rows which we are getting. New R3, new R4, right? Now what is the echelon form says? If at all there is any zero row, that has to come down, the non-zeros, non-zero rows. So let us interchange R3 and R4. So this is what we are saying here. If you interchange R3 and R4, what you get? Let us do that. If you interchange R3 and R4, what you get? 1, 2, 3 minus 1, 0, 1, 1 minus 1. Then if you interchange, 0, 0, minus 4, minus 4 here. So this will come in the down, 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is the matrix now. Here we have 1, fine. Here we have 1, this is also fine. But here we have minus 4, which we want 1 to be in this place. So what is the operation we need to carry? Yes, minus 1 by 4 times R3. That means I need to multiply this row by minus 1 by 4. So that minus into minus, minus into minus plus 4 by 4, 1 becomes 1, right? So this is the operation they are applying here. They are saying this. They have done both the operations in the same matrix. Yes, we have written here. Now let us apply this on this R3. If you apply, what you get is 1 here. Here also you will get 1 because of this minus into minus plus 4, 4 gets cancelled, 1. 4 was the 4. See, now this is in the echelon form. You cannot do anything because this row has become already 0, right? Now, how many non-zero rows are there? 1, 2, 3. Therefore, the rank is 3. Therefore, the rank is 3. Let us find the rank of this. Now again, here if you continue this as it is by maintaining this as 4, it will be difficult for you to make other elements as zeros. It is very difficult to make other elements zeros because it is a larger number than this. Larger number than this. So if you try to make this element as 0, suppose you have 4 here and here you have 2, right? So to make this element 0, we have to divide by 2 first. We have to divide by 2 first or minus 2 or minus 2. Let us divide by minus 2. What you get? 2 ones are 2 twos are, so you will get minus 2. Then you add, we get 0. Fine. But the difficulty is, when this minus 2 has to be divided with this and with this also. So you get minus 1 by 2 here. It becomes very difficult for the operation to carry over here, right? We have to take the LCM and all. So let us interchange these two. Let us interchange these two first. For that reason, we are interchanging the rows. Let us interchange these two. After interchanging these two rows, we got this. Now it is very easy to make these elements 0 with the help of this 2, right? Now how can we make this 4 as 0 with the help of 2? We have 2 here, 4 here. I need to multiply this by minus 2, so it becomes minus 4, then if you add, you get 0. So I need to multiply by minus 2 to the row R1, then add with R2. Minus 2 times R1 plus R2. Similarly, when you take this element, I need to multiply this by minus, then add with 2. Similarly, if you go for this, I need to multiply this by minus, then add this. See, let us apply these operations on this matrix. Yeah, if you apply all these operations on this matrix. You can observe we have brought all these elements as zeros, right? Next, what is our plan? Next non-zero entry is minus 2 here. Below that entry, let us make this element as 0 and this element as 0 with the help of this minus 2. For this also we have to take this minus 2 only. How can we make this element as 0? Let us take minus 2 here and plus 2 here. So what happens now? You just add, you will get 0. It is just R3 changes to R2 plus R3. Then the same thing happens with this. R4 changes to R2 plus R4. If you do that, let us see what we get. If you apply these two operations on these elements, you will get zeros here. Then what is the next non-zero entry? Minus 3. Which lies right to this non-zero leading entry, right? Now what is our aim? Make this element as 0. Below this leading entry, the elements must be 0. Now, how can we make this element as 0? Here we have minus 3. Here we have minus 6. So, we want this to be plus 6 so that if we add, your answer will be 0. So, what number I should multiply now so that it becomes plus 6? I need to multiply by minus 2. So, that minus into minus plus 3 to the 6. So that is what we have taken now. Multiply R3 by minus 2, minus 2 times R3 plus R4. If you apply this operation on this element, let us see what we get. If you apply this operation on this, we will get 0 here, but along with that we are going to get 1 in this place, right? No problem, we are getting 1, not a problem, no problem. Now let us concentrate on making these elements as 1s, as 1. We need to make 1, 1, 1. So to make this element as 1, I need to divide by. To make this element as 1, I need to divide by minus 2. To make this element as 1, I need to divide by minus 3. See, that is what we are doing here. 1 by 2 times R1 minus 1 by 2 minus divide by minus 2. Minus 1 by 2 times R2, then minus 1 by 3 times R3. If you multiply, you get 1 in this place. Let us see what we get. If you apply these operations on these three rows, what you get is this. What you get is? Yes, it is in the echelon form because we have one here and next one is to the right of this leading entry 1, and the next row 1 is again to the right of this one, and the next one is again to the right of this one, and below this one all the elements are 0, below this one all the elements are 0, below this one all the elements are 0. Now how many non-zero rows are there? This is non-zero, this is also non-zero, this is also non-zero, and this is also non-zero because we have non-zero element here. So all the four rows are non-zero after converting it into a row echelon form. So what is the rank of this matrix? Rank of this matrix is 4.